This video, we're going to go through a complete setup of a traditional pinch point wrap labeling system. Right now he's lining up, the technician's lining up the wrap belt with the in-feed guide rail. As you can see, with a straight edge, it's perfectly straight. You would adjust the in-feed guide rail so that it would be perfectly parallel with the wrap station.
I'll find something and
next thing, the technician is taking two cans and then he's going to arrange the opposite guide rail so that the distance between guide rails would be the can diameter plus a 1/16 of an inch. Notice he has two cans, that way he's going to keep those guide rails perfectly straight. Next, technician's going to move the cans into the wrap station. And then he's going to move the backup plate. And he's going to firmly grip the cans. And notice the backup plate and the wrap station are perfectly square. There's no light, you can't see any light between the belt and the backup plate. If there was, then he would have to take a wrench and he would loosen those angles so that he can square up the can or the backup plate with respect to the belt. And the outfeed guide rails, they're not as critical, but we just want to make sure the cans don't fall off the container or fall off the conveyor or get jammed during transfer. Now the technician's going to make sure product flow is very smooth. And the pacing wheel is going to firmly grip the can without denting it. That looked pretty smooth. Let's try it again.
Yep.
What we're looking for is no ricochet whatsoever between the backup plate or the belt. We want to have a smooth transfer when it goes from a linear motion into its circular motion. Looks like we could do a little bit of adjustment on the in-feed guide rail because I did see the product hit this point first, and we don't want that condition. Now we're ready to thread the labeling head. Thank you. Now there is a threading diagram. You have to pay close attention to the threading diagram because the engineer designed the threading of the labeler, and you don't want to improvise a different threading portion, otherwise you're going to basically change the design of the way the labeling head works. And unless you really know what you're doing, pay attention to the threading diagram. Notice he's keeping the labels on the liner. It actually helps keeping the labels on the liner because what it does is it stiffens the web so that you can maneuver it around all the rollers. It's actually a little easier. Now he's going to set up his label flag. There's the optical sensor that detects the label division. And what he's going to try to achieve is 1/4 inch of label sticking off the edge of the peel blade. And he's going to do that using his label delay parameter. Right now, it looks like he needs to add some more label delay. Get that label off the liner. Just gotta add a little more. Good. Now all he's got to do, he's got the label, he's got the product handling set up, he's got the labeler set up. Now he just needs to know the encoder counts between here and when to fire the label. And so he's going to play with his product delay. Pretty good. Okay, what we're looking for is we're looking for the can to start rotating and then the label comes out. That looks just fine. We're done with our setup. And we can run production.